Hello, hello, friends. It's CEO here. And welcome back to my channel. The 1.11 update just arrived to Animal Crossing New Horizons, which introduced new food items your villager can hold, including boba, cotton candy, and frozen treats. So today, I'll show you how to get all these new food items in the game. But really quick, please like this video and subscribe to the channel if you aren't already. Subscribing really helps the channel out so much and lets me keep making these videos for you. Now let's get you some boba, cotton candy, and frozen treats. These food items only appear in the game during the Summer Fireworks Show. The fireworks show takes place every Sunday night during the entire month of August in New Horizons. The fireworks show starts at 7 p.m. sharp on your island's plaza. If you go to the plaza before the designated start time, you won't be able to obtain the boba, cotton candy, or frozen treats. If you talk to Red during this time, he says he'll be running his Red's raffle once the fireworks show starts, which will be how you obtain the new food items. You will also know there's a fireworks show when you load up your game and see Isabelle wearing a cute bopper like the star bopper you see her wearing here. She will announce the fireworks show, so you'll know you'll be good to go to get these new cute food items. During this event, Red has a stand in the plaza where he holds his Red's raffle and sells tickets for 500 bells each. Each ticket is assigned a number, and each one grants you a special prize depending on the number. The ticket you get is random, but it does appear that during your first fireworks show after the update, Red will give you all the tickets that correspond to the new food items first. This is great because we don't have to wait to pull a whole bunch of random tickets to get the new food items. The game is nice to us and spawns them immediately. Once you start buying tickets, this is when you can get the boba, cotton candy, and frozen treats. On the screen are all the new food items you can get with their corresponding ticket numbers. It looks like all the tickets that correspond to new food items go in order, so it's possible more ticket items could be added just by increasing the ticket number. The possibilities are endless, especially since the ticket numbers only go to 24. Just imagine what Nintendo could add next year to this event. More food items perhaps, even wearables? We'll just have to wait and find out. All these new items can be held by your villager and eaten as well. They all have special eating animations which are just adorable. But this wouldn't be Animal Crossing if each item didn't have a secret ability. Each item is allocated 3 sips or bites by your villager. On the 3rd bite or sip, the item disappears as your villager has consumed the whole thing. The cool thing about eating these items is that each bite and sip gives you the ability to dig up a tree, the same as if you eat a piece of fruit. This is great because you can get 3 digging abilities per food item instead of just 1 like from fruits or pumpkins. If you accidentally eat too much boba or cotton candy, you can always take a trip to the toilet to relieve yourself. And that takes care of that. We explored this new update on my Twitch stream, and my chat was wondering if the boba, cotton candy, and frozen treats would be available to order through the catalog. I went ahead and did a search in the catalog for the boba, and it appears you cannot order these items. So the only way you can obtain them for now is during the fireworks show on Sundays in August. The limited availability of these new items doesn't leave you a lot of time for you to get them, unless you time travel to Sundays in August. And for now, only fireworks shows on Sunday nights in August of 2021 have the new food items for purchase. So if you think you can time travel to a different year in August to get these, you can't. Simply, you can't time travel to different years and get the new food items. They are time locked to 2021. I'm sure next year when Nintendo adds the fireworks show for 2022 and 2023 and all the years beyond, you'll be able to get these new food items, but they're not in the game on those years yet. They're only in 2021. Nintendo has been time locking events lately in New Horizons, which wasn't a thing in past games. So you're constrained by the current year and the limitations Nintendo is putting on the game. I'm hoping that once all the Animal Crossing updates have been released, then Nintendo takes away the time lock so these events are available in every year. Because it doesn't make sense that Nintendo is going to be updating the game every year to add in these simple events like the fireworks show. At some point, Nintendo is just going to have to get rid of the time lock so players can play for years and years and years ahead. Someone in my Twitch chat brought up a good point that fireworks, sparklers, and balloons were only available for purchase from Red last year during the fireworks show, but then were added for purchase in Nook's Cranny later on. This could mean we could see boba, cotton candy, and frozen treats added for purchase in Nook's Cranny later down the road, which would be great because their purchase availability is so low right now. We are still waiting for the return of Brewster and his cafe, and data mines have shown Brewster will have a cafe in the museum, just like in previous Animal Crossing games. Once this is added into the game, my prediction is that boba, cotton candy, and frozen treat flavors will be available for purchase through Brewster. It makes more sense for these items to be sold at a cafe rather than Nook's Cranny, unless Nook's Cranny gets a cafe update with a fridge, which is unlikely. I can definitely see an ice cream case, Kant candy maker, and boba fridge in Brewster's Cafe for him to make and sell these treats. I mean, we do already have a Kant candy machine in the game. It would be so cute to see Brewster whip up a Kant candy on the spot in his cafe and hand it to you. If you're interested in exploring new Animal Crossing updates with me live, check out my Twitch channel, where I do Animal Crossing live streams every week. I would love to have you there, and don't be afraid to say hi in chat. This undoubtedly was a smaller update to the game, but I am still excited to have proper food items that you can hold and eat, and these items are just the start. We could see many, many more holdable food items, including sandwiches, soups, and coffees that we already see our villagers walking around with. To me, it makes no sense for Nintendo to have made up these food models for only your villagers to be able to enjoy. I am pretty certain that the human villagers will be able to get these food items in the coming months. My favorite part about this update was definitely the addition of boba, since I love drinking boba, and now I can drink boba in real life and virtually at the same time. It's really a dream come true. The only thing that could have made this update better is if they added taro boba. I see no taro boba, I see no purple boba added into the game, and taro is an S tier flavor, so I really hope maybe next year that we'll see a taro boba added, and then I can really twin with my villager. Let me know in the comments what your favorite item in the update was. I'm really excited about the future of Animal Crossing, and I know there's so much more to come. Please like this video and hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, because it really helps the channel out. My goal is to get that YouTube silver play button, and each and every one of you are part of that goal. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.